look for the end zone. Touchdown!
And the left jab.
Takes the shot.
University of Regina Cougars. Brought to you by...
Ladies, the Regent Park Hair Studio specializes in human hair extensions and long-lasting color. For the men, they provide classic barbering services to leave you feeling refreshed. Located in the Regent Park Mall in Regina.
Well, and welcome to Access 7 Sports. I'm Adam Hunter. Alongside me, Megan Chamberlain. Pleased to bring you University basketball action from the U of R. The home Cougars taking on the Trinity Western Spartans. Cougars coming into this game. The solid first half of the season at 5-3. And the Spartans looking for their first win of the season. They're at 0-8 right now. But looking at some of those scores and talking to Cougar coaching staff before the game, Megan, they said Trinity lost one game to the U of S at the buzzer. They've had a lot of close games, so the Cougars aren't expecting these guys to not be up for it tonight.
Yeah, it's just kind of like the women's game before it. They've had a tough start of their season with who they've had to play. They've had to play UBC, they've had to play Saskatchewan, they've had to play those tough teams. So having them come into this game again, their record isn't really reflective of just how good they are.
We'll set your lineups here in a second. Spartans in the blue and yellow, Cougars in the home whites. And already a steal from Brandon Tall here. Ahead to his brother, JT, to the basket. Oh, and he just sneaks it in. That's not textbook. Tall, like maybe he thought he was pushed or...
I think maybe he thought he was going to get undercut there and might have just freaked himself out a little bit.
So starting for the Cougars, Jonathan and Brandon Tall, the brothers in the backcourt, number 5 and 6. Also joining the Talls, number 4, Alex Igual. Number 15, Will Tallman out there, as well as number 14, Steven Shields. For the Spartans, number 2, Lucas Mattis. Number 4, Sebastian Eliasson. Number 5, Kelvin Smith. Number 7, Vartan Tenelian. And number 14, Patrick Vander Velden.
Good start for the Tulls in 2016 here for the Cougars. They got the 5 opening points.
Old board given up. And another almost old board there, but... offensive foul called to Tenelian. It's 5-0 Cougars. Good start for Coach Burrow's side. Bringing the ball up, Alex Igual from Barcelona. Shields in the high-low from Tallman. Leaves it short. Manis with it.
Tried to shoot over Vander Velden there, but with those arms, I think that's going to be pretty tough to do.
Tend to shoot. Turnaround jump shot there. From Smith is good. And you won't miss Smith on the broadcast. He's wearing the highlighter shoes with the matching headband.
I was going to say, I'd like to see him and Eagle guard each other so we could have that battle of the shoes.
You see more and more crazy shoe combinations, and usually guys and gals, they them try and match close to their uniform, but you got Jonathan Tall is wearing red shoes out there. Vander Velden's got red shoes on.
Got Aaron McGowan on the Cougars bench with his orange shoes, and new addition Pops there with his turquoise shoes.
Yeah, we'll talk about Pops quite a bit. Smith with another fadeaway hits it. Well, 2 in a row for Smith. He's confident. And you got to be confident to rock that headband.
Yeah, and the shoes. The combination of both. It's really... he can back it up with his play so far.
Extra pass to Igual by Vander Velden into the lane. Left hand finish for Alex. Uno dos. Should I try some Spanish out in the second half of the season?
No, I'm going to go with no.
Okay.
Just leave that to me.
Madam Hunter, alongside Megan Chamberlain, happy to be with you on Access 7 Sports. We broadcast every home game, men's and women's, CanadaWest.tv. We're happy to be able to bring the Access viewers the matchup. Tall, nice dish to Shields. and he finishes. So the Cougars really scoring points in the paint early on. 1-3, everything else from inside. 9-4, Cougars lead it. Vandervelde. Young team here in Trinity Western. Smith is the lone fifth-year player. Everyone else in the starting lineup, second or third year. Conversely, the Cougars out there right now, Jonathan Tall in his fifth year. Will Tallman also in his fifth year. And Tall for three, JT is no good. Smith pulls down the rebound.
Alex trying to draw that foul there, but I think the refs caught on to that dive.
Igualt finds Brandon Tall. Numbers in transition. Good dish to Will Tallman. Strong finish for Will Tallman as he holds off Smith, who comes down favoring his arm.
Pretty impressive strength there by Will Tallman to be able to get fouled there on his left hand but still go up with his right and finish.
And Smith looks like he's limping a little bit here. He's trying to walk it off. See if he has to come out. He does. So Will Tallman's going to try and make this double up the Cougar lead here. We're up 11-6 right now. Will nails that one.
Cougars has really started this game on fire. They're shooting 71% from the field.
Peter Spangle into the game for the Spartans, number 9. Placing Smith. Short bench for the Spartans tonight, only 9 players dressed. 10. Oh, check that.
Just walking off his injury there.
You can correct me. You can correct me out loud, Megan.
I don't know why I didn't
talk. Megan was trying to be, you're trying to save my bacon there. Smith was walking it off. So there were 4 players on the bench.
There were.
Miss Smith there. Full board there by the Spartans. You hear the Cougar bench saying box out. Manis for 3, no good. Igual rises up for it. It's a bonus when your point guard can rebound like that. Brandon Tall takes the high screen from Will Tallman. Foul line jump shots long.
Seems like both these teams want to get out and run more than anything.
Jonathan Tall with a piece of that. Brandon Tall pulls it down. Brandon finds his brother. Coach Burrow's asking the team to move it. Igual for 3 straight away. That is in and out. Shields can't grab the full board. Vandervelde pulls it down. And Manis will pull it the other way. Thought he had Elias and steal by Jonathan Tall. Step through. And he rolls it in. That timeout called by Trinity Western. Cougars looking good so far. 14-6, they lead it. 5 minutes played here in the first quarter on Access 7 Sports. We get a look at Smith there. He's back on the bench. See if they can get him back in the game. We'll take a look at that last play here, Megan.
This is a brother-to-brother connection there for the Regina Cougars. And
that was just the first one. Jonathan Tall just squeaking it in. That's how I dunked in my day. Try and pull the rim down, lay the ball in.
No, don't lie.
But that wasn't a dunk.
Don't lie.
I wasn't saying a dunk. Can maybe pull the bottom of the mesh down.
Okay, there
you go. Yeah, there we go.
On your child's net.
Yeah, on an 8-foot rim.
Yeah.
Yeah, Lakewood in the north end. Igual with a nice finish there left-handed. The Cougars doing all their damage here, Megan, in the paint right now.
Yeah, and the Cougar guards are just, they're really explosive on the offensive end. They're hard to guard all across the board. And they can get into that key really, really easily. I mean, the Tull brothers can outrun almost anyone on the court. And you got Alex Eagle, who's got some smooth handles and get by people. And it's pretty special to watch.
And we're still awaiting the debut of Pops Njai, much ballyhooed recruit here from the Cougars in his 4th year. Last played for the University of Tennessee Volunteers. 6'10", listed at 280 pounds. Check that, 6'11". So he's a big fella. Cougar fans here looking forward to seeing him in action.
I know when I saw him walk on the court for the first time, I didn't actually believe he was that big. I was a little surprised.
There's Pops. He's going to add a new dimension to the Cougars here. One thing the Cougars have had in the first half, and we're talking to their coaching staff, they've been really impressed with their bench play. You see Brian Ofori and Aaron McGowan, two guys who contribute quite a bit at the start of the season to that bench group.
Aaron McGowan has been really, really good and very impressive for the University of Regina Cougars. He's hit some big threes for them in games and made some good moves.
Jonathan Tall steps in and takes that charge. It almost happened in slow-mo there. McGowan's out there with Ofori, Jonathan Tall, Brandon Tall, and Stephen Shields. Cougars have an 8-point lead. He's kicked to McGowan. He's open for three. Money from Aaron McGowan right on cue, Megan.
That's such a good pickup for the Regina Cougars. With them losing Matt Augustine for the season with a wrist injury, McGowan fits right in there as the backup point guard, and he's completely willing to accept that role. See, Rogers is back in the game. Not Rogers, sorry, Smith.
Manis, open off the inbound. Rebound by Ofori, and McGowan will look to push here. They skip ahead to Brandon Tall, goes to the basket. Can't get it to go. Good follow by Ofori. And it's a 19-6 for the Cougars.
That haircut.
He's thick, quicker. Brian Ofori proving he's a great teammate, driving, or at least carpooling, with Pops Engi from North Carolina all the way to Regina, which for you geography majors out there, isn't a close, that's not a quick trip. That's hours and hours in the car. So before he picks up the foul there. Five team fouls on the Spartans. That's only the second team foul on the Cougars for the quarter. Some confusion here. Shields will check out. Will Tallman in for the Cougars. At the line, Lucas Manis, second-year player from Chilliwack. Eight now for the Cougars. Solid defense from the Cougars to start the game, while dominating in the paint as well.
Yeah, Coach Burrows has to be pretty impressive to start to the second half of the season. Oh, always jinx things.
Yeah. That?
Good steal there by the sub.
Ofori, the great hustle, footsteps there. The Spartans couldn't finish, and Jonathan Tall goes the other way. He's hit, no call. Steve Burrows wants a call.
I don't think Jonathan Tall is scared of anyone at the rim. I've never seen him back down from contact.
Travel called there. Steve Burrows here talking to referee Mark Jacobson. There's a lot of contact there. He's asking for a foul in the last one. Into the game for the first time for the Cougars, number 8, Mike Malika. Will Tallman's going to look at it and nail it. 3 points for Will Tallman.
I wouldn't give him that much room. He's way more of a shooter than he is a back-to-the-basket player.
Yeah. He's always been a solid shooter. Coached him all the way back in grade 8, Megan. Date myself.
Are you saying that you're the reason he's such a good shooter?
No, absolutely not. Absolutely not. That credit goes to his dad and his coaches all through the years, his older brothers. Brian Ofori. I just tried to stay out of the way. 24-8. Cougars in control here.
Late call there by the referee, but I think he got it right. Got him on the arm.
That's Matt Blackaby. He's listed in the program as wearing number 6, but he's rocking number 13 tonight. Also accessorizing with the long sleeve shirt. So
it's freezing in Regina, so
yeah,
I understand.
That's true, actually. That is true.
I don't know what it's like in Langley, but I'm thinking it's a lot nicer than it is here.
Yeah. Should check that right now. I know it's minus 17, but the wind chill today for a high, I believe, this afternoon.
I think it was reported to get to the 40s with the wind chill. Yeah.
There you go, minus 23. It's chilly out there. We're not telling anyone that's watching this locally that something they don't know, though, so we'll quit talking about the weather. 24-10, Cougars in control here. Spartans doing most of their damage at the foul line. Malika for three, in and out. Big rebound there by Vandervelden. And Blackaby will push ahead. Finds Eliason. Good hustle by Malika to get back. Cougar bench wanted to travel. Vandervelden. In and out, rebound Brandenthal.
Very up-paced game so far for both teams. Really looking to get out and run.
Gown gets hit inside. We need a foul, we're gonna have free throws here. Mary McGowan at the line here. It's fourth year from Toronto. Put it at Fraser Valley.
Again, just a great pickup for the University of Regina Cougars.
Down into second. He'll be replaced by Alex Igual. Guarding Eliason here. Brandon Tall is denying Manis, so it's like the Cougars really don't want him to have the ball. And they cause a turnover here.
If anyone, for everyone that knows Steve Burles, you know he is a defensive-minded coach. He loves that pressure. He loves throwing different defenses at teams, so you can see just with the university, with the how the men are playing, like, big focus on defense tonight.
Igual on top. A block of me to the basket, high off the glass. And in. Real nice finish there. Manis is the leading scorer. Up there in rebounds for his team and assists. So that's the reason why Brandon Tall is basically just denying the ball completely. Oh, a big block by Brian Ofori. And that'll cue the break. Brandon Tall.
Oh, no.
He slipped.
Oh, that's too bad.
That could have been a nice finish, but it's just a huge block by Ofori. Sure we'll see that a couple more times tonight.
If you notice, that's what I love about watching Brian play is he makes the block right at the rim, and he is the second one down the court. He was sprinting and beating everyone down there. He is so athletic. He is so quick. He's fun to watch.
And when you can jump out of the gym like Brian can, there's a reason why you run the other way, because you want that dunk.
Something
I cannot relate to. Eliason. Contact there on the shot, and he'll shoot two. So the Cougars are putting the Spartans on the line, and if you're going to take a shot at anything the Cougars are maybe doing wrong in this one, it's they put the Spartans on the line consistently here. But other than that, a pretty sparkling first quarter. The Cougars close to 30 points. Eliason at the line.
I think that coaching staff down there is pretty happy with the four coaches we have on the bench.
So Eliason's from Denmark. And his hometown is listed as, this is the wrong pronunciation, but Baller Up Denmark. Which is the way you say it in like Saskatchewanese would be Baller Up.
Baller Up.
I'm sure that's not right, but if you're a basketball player, it's not a terrible name.
I think we're going to go with it. I like it.
27-11, Cougars lead at 25 seconds here. In the quarter. Brandon Tall with it. Cougars looking for a good shot here. McGowan finds Malika, 8 to shoot. Good skip to Tolman. Extra pass to Brandon Tall. Can't get it to go. Smith will let it go out of bounds. And the Spartans can hold for the last shot here. 12.9 to play in the first quarter.
It was a great idea there by Will Tolman. Great touch pass. Just good court vision there by the Cougar senior.
And Mattis hits the buzzer beater off glass. Tough shot there. Cougars, a little bit of a scramble play. After the first quarter, Cougars lead it 27-13. We'll be back with the second quarter after this.
University of Regina Cougars, brought to you by.
Ladies, the Regent Park Hair Studio specializes in human hair extensions and long-lasting color. For the men, they provide classic barbering services to leave you feeling refreshed. Located in the Regent Park Mall in Regina.
Don't miss the Viterra Scotties Tournament of Hearts semifinals and final live January 31st at 1 and 5 p.m. For a full schedule, visit myaccess.ca/access7. Rock the house, only on Access 7.
Do you want help getting the word out about your garage sale, public event, or fundraiser? Promote for free on Access 7's community calendar. Submit online by visiting myaccess.ca/access7, clicking on the community calendar section. Community calendar airs daily. Check your local listings for details. Bringing your community to you, only on Access 7.
And Megan, the Cougars here after the first quarter up 27-13. So a really good job on defense for the most part. A few fouls, but the Cougars did a good job on defense here, shutting down Trinity Western as we take a look at some highlights from the first quarter.
That's just an amazing block there by Brian Ofori, especially on a player that's been pretty hot for the Trinity Western Spartans.
A great shot there by Mattis, the leading scorer for the Spartans on the season. 15 a game he's averaging.
And you can see why Coach Burrows has them denying Mattis, because if he can make shots like that, it's scary to think of what he can do in the wide open court. But so far, really, Trinity Western's just had a tough time guarding the Cougars. They're getting to the rim. They're making their outside shots. They just really need to tighten up on the defensive end.
Look at the Cougar coaching staff.
Matching down there, the two of the assistant coaches,
for the
same
most
shirts.
Part, yeah. Nothing in the budget for Dougherty to get a shirt. McGowan wide open to start the quarter, has to take it. Good tip out there by Brian Ofori. Brandon Tall is surrounded by blue shirts, draws a foul. Goes Strange starting the quarter there. Aaron McGowan left wide open. And I'm sure that Spartans coaching staff is wondering what's going on with his team.
Still
a little bit sleeping there out of the quarter.
Maybe still in Christmas break a little bit, just needing to get back in it somehow. Maybe it's of all the people to leave open, especially Aaron McGowan, who's knocked down his first three and is known to be a great three-point shooter. It's just strange leaving wide open like that.
Brandon Tall hits one of two from the line. Cougars have a 15-point lead here. We start the second quarter. Looking to post a 40. It's the 7-footer. Matt Hayashi.
He had the post up. They just threw the pass to the wrong side.
Good hands by McGowan. 7 to shoot. Mattis goes to the basket. Before he gets a piece, and the Cougars will go the other way. Nice hit ahead. McGowan, Tull, off the glass and in. The Cougars are just having their way in transition, Megan. Not much resistance by the Spartans.
Yeah, and it's not, they have some bodies back, the Spartans, but they're not stopping the ball. It's getting down the court in 1 or 2 seconds. They need to have someone pick up the ball right away and slow it down.
For the Cougars, it's Igual, McGowan, Ofori, Tolman, and Brandon Tall, Smith, Mattis, Yashi, Vandervelden. Three on the way is no good. Rogers also out there for Trinity Western, number 8.
Nice pass. I think everyone thought that shot was going up.
And it was caught there, and at last minute found the net inside. Rogers
Trinity Western has fallen back into a zone here, just hoping to maybe plug up some lanes.
Oh, great look by McGowan before he throws it down with one hand. If you're going to go into a zone, you still got to guard someone.
Yeah, that was... It's kind of the misconception with zones is a lot of the time, especially you see it in the high school, it's people think it's a lazy defense, but when really it's a tough defense to play and it's a tough defense to play against. As long as you have your arms out and you're clogging up those lanes, that was just too easy for Aaron McGowan to get in between people there.
Cougars in control here, 32-15. Shields into the game, replacing Ofori. Give the Cougars some good minutes there. Good look by McGowan to Tallman. And he hits the three.
Again, that was just straight penetration from the top. Like, the two top people weren't guarding anyone, and just leads to a wide open three for Will Tallman. So great offense by the Cougars. I don't even know if they're running any plays right now. They're just kind of playing basketball.
So Igual. Cougars will set something up. Jonathan Tall in the corner. Back-to-back threes on the way. In and out. All the way around. Steven Shields battling for it. Manis comes away with it. And Manis finishes. He's tough inside there. We have a timeout. Cougars. So 35-17. Cougars lead at 7.5 to go. And that's the guy for the Cougars. They had to stop him from getting in the key.
See, and that was a great take by Manis. So I'm not sure what Steven Shields is doing there. He didn't get back or there was nothing in there for him.
Slow down the ball handler. There's a little collision there as Igual comes down with a rebound. Rogers knocks him down.
Good sportsmanship there, though. Helps him right back up.
You would have walked over him, right?
Oh, yeah. Obviously. There's Brian Ofori with that nice haircut, helping him dunk.
We're here to bring you the haircut news as well. We were talking about the women's game. McGowan, that good look ahead.
That's again, no one was on McGowan. If you watch that replay, no one was even close to him.
And that good look inside as Smith almost got caught in between there.
But that's just too easy if you're for Trinity Western.
Once again, McGowan just splitting the defense.
He's just kind of having his way right now there with the assists.
Well, like you said, not doing anything special, just attacking the defense and not getting much resistance. Seven and a half to play here in the first half. Cougars 18-point lead in control against Trinity Western.
You can see Trinity Western's gone back to a man-to-man defense coming out of that timeout.
Four to shoot. Jonathan Tull stepped out on the sideline. The turnover out of the timeout there by the Cougars. And here comes Pops. Pops Ndiaye coming off the Cougar bench. We'll see our first action of the big man.
I've been looking forward to this since he was announced. As a recruit, you can hear the
appreciative crowd. Yeah. You see the newest Cougar wearing number 10. You won't miss him on the court, guys.
Because of his shoes.
That's right. We have a 6'11 guy on a 7'1 guy. That doesn't usually happen in Canada West.
Oh,
my
wow.
Goodness. Jonathan Tall with the ridiculous block right into our camera there on the baseline.
That was special. That was awesome.
That was ridiculous. You never see a guy get blocked on a three like that.
I don't know if you guys heard the grunt through the microphone, but that was pretty impressive as well.
He blocked that and then didn't realize that he could go get the ball. That's a... Yeah, we'll take a look at that block by Jonathan Tall. So the guy's queued up. Great job, guys. And watch this. Eliason? No.
He's so athletic. Oh, there's no way to describe it. If you're from Regina and you're watching this right now, you need to come down and see him play.
These guys are something else.
It's his last year. And
he's a treat.
Yeah.
Good defense by Igual there. Shields picks it up, and the Cougars are off to the races again.
Look at Pops go.
Pops running down the floor, and Jonathan Tall finishes it. 39-17 now for the Cougars. Mattis with the pull-up three.
You can definitely see why Coach Burrows is trying to deny him the ball completely.
He's got 9 points. He's been most of the offense here for his team. Good look inside to Pop. He's fouled from behind by Vandervelden.
McGowan gets through these holes where I don't know. He goes into them, and I don't think he's going to make it out. And all of a sudden, he shows up, and it's his handles are just great.
He's very steady out there.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll see Pops Ndiaye at the line. And he's one for one as a Cougar. And I'm talking to the coaching staff before the game. They said he's nervous. Hasn't played in a little while. Injured a knee, and that's why he's left the University of Tennessee. He had finished school there. He can come up here and play in 10 schools. So
you can say right now he's 100% as a Cougar. So I don't think he needs anything to be nervous about.
When you're 6'11" guy can hit free throws like that, that's also a nice sign.
Yeah, no DeAndre Jordan or Shaquille O'Neal problem
right
here.
Ndiaye out there guarding the roller. Cougars all over these guys defensively, but foul on the jump shot. And trying to judge the reaction there. I wasn't sure if Cougars were disappointed that they fouled or if that there was a foul call. But nevertheless, Smith is at the line, Calvin Smith, fifth-year player out of L.A. Going to cut into this Cougar lead, and he does. He was 2 for 2 from the line, 19-point Cougar lead here, 5:50 to play in the first half here on Access 7 Sports. I'm Adam Hunter alongside former Cougar Megan Chamberlain. Thanks for joining us.
Trinity Western's gone back into that 2-3 zone.
Igual, nice kick to Malika, extra pass to Tall. Goes right to the basket and lays it in.
You know, the Cougars are just having their way getting into those lanes there in that zone.
Good hands by McGowan, gets the steal. Cougars are going to run. McGowan finds Jonathan Tall all the way in. Can't get it to go. Picks it up. Finds Igual. Kicks to Malika, three-pointer on the way. In and out. Mattis, pull up three.
He's left open, no one picked him up.
He's deadly from out there.
Great find there for Trinity Western.
12 points for him. Leading his team. McGowan finds Igual, he'll shoot the three. That's money, Alex Igual. 21-point Cougar lead.
What's interesting is because they've gotten into the zone and the lane so many times and kicked to their post right down low for a quick layup, the Trinity Western is starting to collapse right inside. There's about two or three people on Pops as they're driving, and it leaves the three-point shooters wide open.
Facing it out by Tall. He's blocked, though. Good defense by Trinity. Cougars, as this game goes back and forth, both teams a little bit winded. No reset on the shot clock, though. And right now, 10 to shoot. Mattis with it. And it'll go back to 14 here. The kick ball. 4:05 to play here in the first half. Cougars in control, 46-25. Vandervelden back in for Trinity Western.
Good shift there by Pops, getting a nice applause here from the crowd.
Timeout Trinity, 46-25, 21-point Cougar lead here. 4 minutes and change to play here in the first half. A lot for Trinity to talk about here as they're trying to keep the Cougars out of the McGowan there. On a shooter, you kind of got to step out and make him a dribbler.
I mean, you have Stephen Shields and Pops behind you to guard that rim for you. But
it was a great run here from Pops. He's there for the rebound if Paul misses. And then another transition play there. McGowan once again.
Yeah, he's just deadly. Manis from outside.
You got to find him early in transition. And then speaking of deadly from outside, Alex Igual. He's got 7 on the game.
We say he's on fuego.
On fuego. Very good.
Thank you. Took Spanish in grade 12.
Dos cerveza, por favor. That's the most Spanish that people from Saskatchewan know. Getting down to Puerto Vallarta. Or
that's because the flights are cheap to Mexico.
Huatuco.
I've tried to get Alex to teach me something to say on air,
yes.
But no luck yet.
Yeah, I'd love a Spanish nickname or something. It'd be great.
Yeah.
I really should be doing uno dos tres when he hits a 3.
Uno dos tres.
We're working it out loud to you guys out there.
Everyone's really interested in this conversation.
46-25, 4-5 to play. Cougars in the lead. McGowan, Malika, Igual, Ofori, and Jonathan Tall for the Cougars. Calvin Smith with it for Trinity Western. He's got a great-looking jump shot. He's hit 3 from that exact spot on the court.
I think they've been step-backs every time, and I don't think one's even hit the rim yet.
Once again, that 2-3, Megan.
Let's see if Cougars can get some penetration here.
Malika from the corner, in and out. And Manis with it. Ofori, great job there. Gain the mix, and we'll have a tie-up. Team Malika and Tanellian.
Burrows isn't happy with that call.
Should make the refs see what's going on here. Arrow stays with Trinity Western. Manis on Malika. Off the glass, no good. Igual pulls it down. Cougars have numbers. Good look. Someone's another slip there.
I have to wipe that floor off a little bit. I think that's twice now Jonathan Tull has slipped.
We got to get Brandon slipped once. We got to get Conchu. Where is he? Braden Conchu. Let's wipe the floor, Braden. Everybody's slipping.
He's gone. We can't find him.
46-27. Brian Ofori at the line, 3:15 to play here in the first. A little flat on the first one.
That's one criticism probably of Brian's game. Something he needs to work on is that outside shot. He's super athletic and he's good in the post, but he just needs to develop that outside shot a little bit more.
Will Tallman into the game for the Cougars. Mike Malika checks out. Brandon Tall is in there. Cougars showing a bit of pressure there in the backcourt. Good defense by Ofori on the big man. McGowan ahead, Igual. Cougars will set up their offense. High ball screen here from Ofori. Gown uses it in the lane. Kick. Brandon Tall. Left hand drive. Has the bounce pass inside to Ofori. Can't handle it. Knocks it out. That's knocked out by Blackaby. Sam Hillis into the game for the Cougars. Number 2 for the first time. First year player. He's open on the 3-point line. Igual's wide open. Shot clock buzzer. .234 to play, 20-point Cougar lead.
See if Manis can get something going here for the Trinity Western Spartans.
Is that point in the game where the Cougars, they've been kind of stuck on that 20-point lead for a while. And they're really trying to get to that next level and push it. Because you want to make that 20-point lead a 25-point lead and not give Trinity Western anything, any life before the half year.
It's just kind of become a standstill almost.
Yeah.
Not that much energy going on since the Jonathan Tall block, it seems like.
Smith set the line, and one rolls out. Foul was on Brandon Tall, it's his first. Only 2 career team fouls this quarter. Cougars will be shooting the bonus on the next Spartans foul.
Spartans really switching between that man-to-man and that zone defense, just trying to make the Cougars take an extra second here to decide what they're going to run.
Nice tough take inside by Brandon Tall. And Mattis takes it the other way. Smith's going to get the and one here.
He's kind of redeemed himself. I know he was mad about that last miss layup and made an even tougher one.
The Cougars still up 17 here, but lacking, as Megan mentioned, a little bit of energy to finish this half off.
No, I'm not sure. I think they just called no basket on that one, so it's actually going to be two foul shots. It's interesting. I don't know. I'm guessing the foul must have occurred then way before he shot it, but to me, with the whistle and the sound, it sounded exactly like he was going up.
I'd be a little upset if I was one of the Spartans or the coaching staff there. Instead of being a three-point play, you're getting one. So a bit of a break there for the Cougars. He's from our angle up here. Igual finds Tallman, trying to post up a four inside. And then they say shuffle him.
Just took that extra step there, slid his feet.
Cougars without one of their most experienced players. Has started quite a few of the games this year. Travis Sylvester, number 7, he's out with an injury. Not sure when he'll be back. Eliason shoots the three, that's no good. And the Cougars are running. Miguel finds Tallman, look inside to Ofori. And he goes glass.
Pretty tough shot there to get it over the 7-1 foot arms there. His arms aren't 7-foot one, that would be insane.
Cougars really balanced scoring attack tonight. Smith airballs the three. Eliason picks up the rebound. And he's fouled. He'll shoot two.
It's on the rookie there, Sam Hillis. Just missed his box out a little bit.
Sebastian Eliason at the line. Spartans struggling from the line tonight, at least recently. First quarter they were good. 1-2 there. 19-point Cougar lead, 52 seconds here to go in the first half. And Brandon Tall with the and one.
Great strong finish there from Brandon Tall. Biggest difference right now is Regina shooting 50% from the field and the Spartans are 27%. So
the Cougars are shooting from right and close too.
Yeah.
They've been doing that the whole game.
A lot of points in the paint.
Brandon Tall hits on the three-point play, pushes it to a 22-point lead. Sam Hill is pressuring Eliason here a little bit off the three-point line. Brandon Tall is trying to deny Mattis the ball. 8 seconds. See, Burrow's asking for a double to get the ball away from him. Smith to the basket. And a big block by Ofori. Sam Hillis pulls it down. And Brandon Tall goes the other way and lays it in. All around, a great play by the Cougars. Defense to offense. 9 seconds to play here. Mattis from way downtown. That's long. Rebound by Igual. Finds Ofori for three. Oh, and the crowd wanted that one. At the half, the Cougars lead it 54-30. A great second quarter from the Cougars. To follow up a good first quarter, and we'll be back with second half action. Well, we'll take a quick look at a replay here before we send you for the break. So here we have Ofori. The nice bounce pass down to Tall. Gathers.
That's just a good, strong finish.
And then here the transition bucket by Brandon Tall after the great defensive possession there by the Cougars.
Which if you're a Cougar fan, that's probably deja vu. You see Brandon Tall making that run a lot.
54-30 your halftime score. We're back with the second half action on Access 7 Sports after this.
University of Regina Cougars, brought to you by.
Ladies, the Regent Park Hair Studio specializes in human hair extensions and long-lasting color. For the men, they provide classic barbering services to leave you feeling refreshed. Located in the Regent Park Mall in Regina.
Look at you, sitting there watching TV. You should get off that couch and watch TV. With Access, you can watch TV anywhere you want. Get off that couch and go to technologythatworks.ca.
Don't miss the Regina Pats battle it out against the PA Raiders in Prince Albert. Live Friday, February 12th at 7 p.m. Only on Access 7.
From the prairies to the pros, discover why Saskatchewan rules the NHL. Watch Hometown Hockey Heroes, Wednesdays at 7 p.m., only on Access 7.
What's on TV? How fast is the internet? The answers to life's questions are at My Access Builder. It's where you find the services Access has to offer and save money picking the perfect package. Everything you want is waiting.
Welcome back to Access 7 Sports coverage of the University of Regina Cougar basketball. I'm Adam Hunter alongside me, former Cougar Megan Chamberlain. We get to start the second half here. Cougars and Trinity Western Spartans, as you look at Coach Steve Burrows of the Cougars. He's pretty happy with his first half. His team leads 54-30 at halftime. And that blue shirt really bringing out Steve Burrows' blue eyes.
I was just going to say, that was like, that was a nice shot there with those eyes, those baby blues. You know, the Cougars really did have an impressive first half. I mean, any team that puts up 54 points in a half is it's going to have some success.
Cougars have the arrow. As we start the second half, we'll set your lineups for you. For the Cougars, Brandon and Jonathan Tall in the backcourt, along with Alex Igual. Up front, Steve Shields and Will Tallman. And for the Spartans, Elias and Manis, Vanderveld and Smith. And finally, Tenelian. Three-pointer on the way is no good. Vanderbilt, check that Hayashi.
It's a good start there for Smith. He's really had a good game so far in the first half. Continuing that over to the second.
It's and one there, and a little clumsy push in the back by the Cougars on Jonathan Tall. It's his first foul and the first team foul, but a good start here, as you mentioned, Megan, as Smith completes the three-point play. 13 points for him.
With all the focus on Manis, I think it's giving Smith an opportunity to get to the hoop a little bit easier. And he's really taking advantage of it.
He's moving side to side. Igual. Shields is going to take the three ball. And he nails it, Steve Shields.
I think just judging on the reaction there from the bench, it doesn't happen very often.
Shields was strutting back, though. He liked that one.
He is a good shooter. He is known to have been a good shooter. He's pretty good friends with a shooter, Sterling Nosted, from a couple years ago. And I think Sterling taught him a few things.
The Brandon connection. 57-36. His team's trading three-point trips. Jonathan Tall's hammered inside. And he'll go to the line. Well, Trinity Western, six quick points out of the half. A three-point play and then a traditional three-pointer.
Smith now has 16 points to lead his team, and he's playing quite well. He's shooting 50% from the field.
Jonathan Tall at the line here. He's got 11 points. Yeah, Manis and Smith, they're 1-2 points, averaging 15 and 13 respectively on the season. And they'll probably both get to that. Well, Smith's already surpassed it. Three more for Manis will get into his season average. Paul hits them both from the line, and the Cougars' lead is 23. Smith posting Will Tallman, likes that turnaround off the dribble. Step back, gets the space,
Good box up by the Cougars. Shields gets the rebound, and it goes to Alex Igwall. Nice inside out cross by Igwall. Goes glass, no good. Manis, the other way for Trinity Western. Good defense and transition there by Jonathan Tall. Manis gets his own rebound, kicks it to Tenelian. He shoots the three, no good, and JT comes down with it.
And just looking at the scoring here for Trinity Western, you've got Manis at 12 and Smith at 16, and then four players with 2 points.
Brandon Tall to the basket, and he gets the roll. And he scores so many of those that people don't even react, but he's constantly putting those up in traffic with pressure. He gets the steal here, head ahead to his brother. Jonathan Tall's foul.
What's that counted, but I'm not sure that was... That and you were close?
No, I wasn't getting to the rim.
No.
Worth it for asking, though.
A for effort on that one, trying to get that basket to count. It's been a real treat to have John Tall, who joined last season, to play with his final 2 years with his brother. It's been a real treat to watch those two play together.
61-36 here. Jonathan Tall at the line.
Gotta say, they're also some of the nicest guys I think you'll ever meet. Those two brothers are extremely respectful and just amazing basketball players.
Yeah, lucky to have them here in Regina. Come on down and check them out. A few home games left. Tall misses the second. Tipped up, tipped by Tallman to Tall. Seven to shoot. Nice take by Igwall again. He's had two in a row there that just rolled out.
Smith is really looking to be aggressive here in the start of this.
Smith just...
Third quarter.
Brushed aside Igwall like he was a running back running down the sideline. And then...
Or Kobe Bryant last night taking out that referee.
Yeah, yeah. Manis, good defense there by Brandon Tall. Back to Manis.
Brandon Tall has been all over Manis tonight. Made it really difficult, though. He has 12 points, but he's earned every single one of them.
Vandervelden, that's no good. Cold shooting continues for the Spartans. Jonathan Tall inside to Steven Shields, and he finishes it off nicely inside.
It's a nice thing about the Cougars is right there, you'd think that Jonathan Tall might have pulled up for the three, but he wants to attack, he wants to get the ball inside and get those easy layups.
And here's the five Cougar starters right now. 13-13-7-7-9.
Not
everyone's
a bad
doing
stat line there.
Very good.
Brandon down for a little bit. Hopefully he's okay. Always good sportsmanship here in the CIS.
By Manis to Vandervelden. Fouled by Shields, even though it looked like Vandervelden skipped through the lane there.
I think Shields is going to have a tough time blocking any shot that Vandervelden puts up there with those long arms.
Patrick Vandervelden, second year player. Abbotsford, 6'9". 170 though, so he's going to put a little meat on that frame. I'm sure he will over the course of the next 3 years. And a tough player. 4 points for him on the night. Cougars lead at 64-38.
Trinity Western has had a tough season, but if you're looking at the years that they have and the
it's
veterans, it's very young team. They really have Kelvin Smith and Jesse Jeffers as their only 2 fifth years, and most of the other guys are second and third, so they'll be good in the next few years.
A foul is on Manis, it's his second. He go all the way to the basket for two. And you can tell, Megan, we talked about the first half of Cougars getting to the lane, pretty much at will, in the lane. And the defense for Trinity Western has been extended out, but still equal able to get to the basket there. And he's going to have a steal here, a chance for another one, as he goes in for the layup.
You can see, like, just looking at the stats, points in the paint, Trinity Western 6, Regina 36.
Wow.
Now 38.
And that's the total for Trinity Western. So the Cougars have as many points in the paint as Trinity Western has points total. I'm going to take a look here. Smith goes into transition.
Nice take there by Smith. Just avoiding that charge at that sidestep.
There's Deep Shields from the deep, deep three.
He doesn't look like he'd be a three-point shooter, but he can definitely knock those down.
There's Smith for three. Three of a 16 there. And Brandon Tall with that tough, tough hoop inside. Going to his left.
His body control is just amazing, how he can be drifting that far and still be able to get a good shot off.
Alex with a nice take there, left-hand finish. And good anticipation on the steal there. Iguals with four quick ones. He's got 11 on the night. Another player in double figures joining the Tall brothers. Will Tallman's next point. We'll put him in double figures. Shields has seven. Ofori and McGowan have been good as well for the Cougars on the offensive end. So, I mean, to have 70 points, we've only played 4 minutes here of the half.
Yeah, Coach Burrows has to be happy there on that sideline, showing the first game back from 2016, where some teams might have a lot of rust and need a little bit to get into it. The Cougars have really come out hot from the start.
Tallman open for three. Trinity Western's emptied their bench here. Some five new players in. Brandon Tall almost gets it to go. We'll check the lineup here for you. Let you know who's in the game for the Spartans. Number 12, Matt Hayashi's in. Also out there. Matt Blackaby is wearing number 13 tonight. We have number 8, Eric Rogers. And number 9, Peter Spangle. And for the first time tonight, we're seeing number 10, Fraser Curry, first-year player from Ottawa. With five starters for the Spartans getting a talking to over on the sideline there.
It's not that the Spartans are a bad team. I just think they're having a really tough time on the defensive end. Obviously, with the 70 points the Cougars put up with 15 minutes left here, but things are just too easy. There's a crossover right by someone. They need to play tougher on-ball defense in order to be successful.
A little lazy defense there by the Cougars. Called for the reach. The Spartans doing a good job. Coming off screens hard. That's what you got to do when you get subbed in as five guys, and you got to kind of show the coach, hey,
my turn.
Yeah, gonna run off the bench in the middle of the game. And Blackaby with it. Two to shoot. Nice jump shot there.
Shot there by Jeff. Oh no, that's not Jeffers, is it? Blackaby.
Blackaby, fourth-year player from Maple Ridge. Mike Malika looking for the answer. Can't get his go from three.
Yeah, that was a good box out there by Trinity Western.
Steal here by Ofori. McGowan. And lay it in. Aaron McGowan for two. 72-40. This is a 32-point leader for the Cougars. McGowan, Ofori, Tolman, Malika, and Brandon Tall out there. Check that Igual out there.
Cougars have really made the most of the turnovers from Trinity Western. They have 19 points off turnover so far in this game.
Floater, two on the shot clock. Big rebound by Will Tallman. Finds Aaron McGowan. McGowan wanted Ofori on the alley-oop. Malika looking for his first three of the game. Still can't get one to go. Open looks though.
Nice move.
Good help defense there by Malika.
It's a lot of passing going on for Trinity Western, not a lot of shots.
Oh, and Tallman fouled with not much time left there. And Will Tallman's asking for 3 seconds of the key. Pop Senjak coming back in along with Sam Hills for the Cougs.
I think I've pulled that one before where it wasn't a foul. He was in the key for 10 seconds.
Trinity Western has the Houston Rockets style uniforms. Big fella here with a bit of a little hesitation here in the free throw.
think that
pops us in early there.
But yeah, a little bit.
Free throw, second free throw is good for the Spartans. Cougars lead is 31. 3:50 to play here. They're trying to get Pops the ball inside. They finally look to him. Nice turnaround. Can't get it to go. Good crash by Ofori. Good defense there by Spartans, and it's going to be a foul on Sam Hillis, I believe.
It was a good first move there by Pops. Good way to use his body and shield those long arms away from it.
I have a feeling this last 3 minutes here of the third quarter is going to take a little time because both teams are going to be in bonus. And 30-point lead. You have a lot of bench players in there. See a bit of a scrappy last 3 minutes here. Fraser Curry, the lefty at the line.
He's rocking that long sleeve too.
Yeah, a couple long sleeves. Rolls around and in. Injai. Mouth cards.
Travel there a little bit. That's one of my pet peeves is if you have a mouth guard.
Yeah, chewing on it. Chewing on the mouth guard. 3 minutes to play here in the third. Blackaby for three. That's in and out. The box up by the Cougars.
It's a nice play drawn up there by Trinity Western, though, to get that wide open three.
McGowan with it. We'll survey the situation. Finds Edgeye. Can't get it to go. Trinity Western will go the other way. Curry, good defense by Sam Hillis. He'll stay with the Spartans here.
You can tell Pops is a little nervous. He really wants to get that first basket.
Yeah.
A true basket as a Cougar.
Jumper there by Fraser Curry. He's got four quick points. And it's 72-45 now.
Oh man, that's a good screen.
Pops.
And he lost his mouth guard.
I don't know how that Spartans ball, to be honest.
I can always tell him Coach Burrows is upset with a with a call because he gives the hands out look and then slumps his shoulders and walks away. Like he can't believe that just happened. But we're up here.
That's right. Brian Ofori, Coach Burrows having a little chat there. Burrows wasn't happy with something that he saw in defense. 72-45 Cougars.
Trinity Western has their starters back in the game. Maybe a little talking to from the coach is going to spark them here.
Sam Hillis for three. It's in and out. Gets his own rebound, though. Good hustle. He'll try it again. Why not?
Same spot.
And Manis comes the other way on McGowan. Can't get it to go. Good rebound by Hillis.
They got numbers here if they push.
McGowan will draw the foul.
Nice take by McGowan. I think I'm just as excited as Pops for him to get his first basket because I didn't want that foul to be called.
There he is, the newest Cougar. Pops Enjai. Aaron McGowan at the line. The new Cougar this year. Down now is seven. Make it eight. Seventy-four, 45 Cougars, 1:39 to play here in the third. Still the whole quarter here, folks.
Oh, it was actually Vanderbilt in his fourth foul, so coach subbed him out there.
Good catch there, Megan. So are you getting paid all the money tonight?
No.
Will Tallman back in the game for the Cougars. Pops Angel, I'll sit down. Replaced by Brian Ofori.
Burrows is giving him some, a little lesson.
Malika for three. That's in and out. Big rebound by Ofori. He loads up.
I think, yeah, he took a few steps there. I think it would have been okay if he had gone up with it right away, but took a few steps and then stopped and waited to draw the foul, so.
Close to a 5-second call there.
Good heads-up play by Ofori to try to get that steal.
Good defense by Malika.
Nice save there by Mike Malika.
And McGowan finishes off glass.
That gets him into double digits.
The Burrows wanted a foul there. I think I agree with him.
Now got four Cougars in double digits tonight. And actually, since the last time we talked about Trinity Western scoring, Manis and Smith are still at 12 and 16. They haven't scored in a while. So good work by the Cougars there.
The Cougars fall asleep on the old glass there, on D glass, I should say. Three in a row, the Spartans, and Eliason will shoot two free throws. Sebastian Eliason at the line. It's them both. Be replaced by Blackaby.
Nice play. Lost the ball going up there.
And Manis picks up the loose one. 76-49. Malika again for three. And at the end of the third, the Cougars lead at 76-49. We'll be back with the fourth quarter on Access 7 Sports right after this.
University of Regina Cougars, brought to you by.
Ladies, the Regent Park Hair Studio specializes in human hair extensions and long-lasting color. For the men, they provide classic barbering services to leave you feeling refreshed. Located in the Regent Park Mall in Regina.
The story of the Royal Canadian Mounted Police. Part of your heritage. Watch Heritage in Scarlet. Only on Access 7.
Technology should make your life easier and more fun. You shouldn't have to wait for it. It should keep moving with you. And it should solve your problems. That's technology that works. That's Access.
We're back on Access 7 Sports. University of Regina Cougar basketball. The man in control tonight against the Trinity Western University Spartans. All Cougars. I'm Adam Hunter alongside me, Megan Chamberlain. And Megan here, the Cougars, once again in the third. Bit of a sloppy third quarter, but Aaron McGowan here, he's been good. Somehow didn't get a foul call there.
Yeah, I'm not sure why that wasn't a foul call, but getting a little bit of a sloppy play. But here's Manis getting his 14th point of the game. And if you're Trinity Western at this point, the game's a little bit out of reach, and I'm not sure they can come back from this deficit at this point. But you want to find something that you can go into tomorrow with, because they do have another game tomorrow at 4 o'clock here.
Yeah.
So you just want to find some positives.
It's important to get some momentum and maybe find some guys on offense that can help Manis and Smith out.
Well, yeah, because like we mentioned, it's Manis with 14, Smith with 16, and then a couple guys with 4 points. So they're gonna need some help there on the offensive end, and they also need to figure out a defense they can play against these Cougars.
Much more competitive third quarter by Trinity Western, only down by three against the Cougars in that third quarter, but Cougars still in control here, and Coach Burrows I know, wants a strong finish. She doesn't want to give this team any life. Nice three-pointer there.
Good start to the fourth quarter from Trinity Western Spartans. But yeah, if you're Trinity Western, you're looking for something to go into tomorrow with positive. But if you're the Cougars, you want to kind of leave no doubt in Trinity Western's mind that, hey, you can't play with us, or like it'll help for tomorrow and maybe dampen their spirits a little bit.
And Malika hits a three. It's got to feel good. He's had a few, you know, near misses out there. So he answers Sonillion's free. And they're going back and forth at each other here. Big board by Malika. And that'll be the third foul on Barton Tenellian.
A lot of fans out there tonight.
Yeah. Ofori on the roll. Nice left hand finish.
Good switch in the air to get that ball off.
81-52. Manis Snellian inside. That's Peter Spangle. Manis by Will Tallman. Good defense by Malika, but Smith there to clean it up.
Big Manis just kind of sized up Will Tallman there and decided to take the ball right by him. It's an errant pass. It's a tough one to throw.
Good recovery there by Brandon Tall. Mm-hmm. Good defense.
Still on the ground, getting a hand from referee Warren Ponczak.
The Cougars call a timeout here. Leading 81-54, 8:17 to go in the game. Burroughs here talking to Brian Ofori.
So good effort there by Manis. I mean, that's what you want to see. You're down 27, but your star player is still going for the ball, still going for the steals, like giving his body for the team. That's the kind of effort you want from these 20 Western Spartans.
Which Burroughs called the timeout, and he's spending it talking to Brian Ofori. Always teach him.
Everything about defense. I bet you they're talking defense. Burroughs is a special coach. He was the assistant coach for the women's team and the men's team for a while here at the U of R, and you can learn so much from just sitting down and talking to him for 30 minutes, and all of his players respect him.
Yeah. He's my high school coach.
Yeah. Yeah. Winston Knoll?
That's right.
Yeah.
Don't ask about my game, though. He is complimentary as he is and the nice guy as he is. It'd be tough for him to say anything nice about that, but... He's a great guy, good coach, and the Cougars, the university lucky to have him here running the show. Aaron McGowan for three. No good, big rebound by Ofori. Finds a cutting Brandon Tall. A little pep talk about Brian Ofori going there on the old glass.
These points in the paint are just insane to look at that stat. 10 for Trinity Western, 46 for Regina.
Looks like a travel by Smith. And a bit of a bailout there. Blackbee's going to come back in. Check that. That's Frazier Curry. Got my long sleeve shirt guys mixed up.
They're both on now, so good luck.
Yeah.
We still know who Smith is.
Yeah, Smith's got the... Yeah. Can't miss him with that haircut and the bright yellow / green head now. Hits them both. He's got 20. Got a whistle here. Shot clock.
Start there.
83-56, Cougars lead, 7:43 to play.
Brandon Tull leaned a little bit on that screen. Good catch there by referee.
Third foul on Brandon Tull. Come on.
Will Tallman on Manis right now. Interesting matchup.
They're just trying to get him to go to the basket and give it up.
Will Tallman is a
Ofori goes coast to coast and throws it down.
I don't know how he... Actually, I know how he did that. He's incredibly athletic, but that was... He's putting on a show.
Yeah, he's playing well, and Smith continues to get to the foul line for Trinity Western. Let's take another look at Ofori, the big man going coast to coast. One thing in mind, and just hammers it down.
It's nice to see that replay, because him coming out, you can tell he's thinking about it the entire way. Like, what should I do? What dunk should I pull out?
Most of the guys for Trinity Western on the floor right now are, you know, sub 6'5", so they're backing away. Smith had a good game offensively here, 22. He'll check out. Seven-footer. Matiashi back in. And Stephen Shields in for Will Tallman.
Haven't seen much of John Tull or Alex Eagle yet this half, but maybe resting them a little bit as they are the older guys on the team.
Tie up. Possession arrow. Going to stay here with the Cougars. We've got a reset here, so put my brother on the sideline over there saying 8 to shoot. Shot clock was at 23. They got it back to 8.
You're just name dropping now because you have a brother?
No.
Assistant coach?
No, I should call him out actually. Things are going well though, so can't put any blame on him. Malika for 3. That's no good. And that's all last off the Cougars. 85-58. 6:30 to play. Brandon Tolt on the deck. Picks himself up.
That's one of the easiest rebounds I think he'll ever get in his life, but
Cougars just a little flat-footed on defense right now.
It is hard to keep yourself in these kind of games, but it's all about the mentality and being strong enough to do so.
And I think Coach Burrows is kind of keeping an eye on the Trinity Western lineup here and seeing if they take Manis off. Maybe he'll go to his bench a little bit.
They called intentional foul here.
I didn't see that. And Brandon Tall is going to shoot. Was it 1 or 2?
It's a technical foul there on Manis.
Okay, so Manis has now got 4 fouls.
So personal foul on Manis, technical foul on Manis. Is that progression there?
So he has 4. He's going to sit down.
Sure what happened. He must have said something to the referees they didn't like.
Aaron McGowan at the line to shoot the tee. And he gets the friendly roll. So Cougars are 2 or 3 from the line on that trip. With personal on the tee. 87-58. The home side in front here. As the fourth quarter ticks down. Adam Hunter alongside Megan Chamberlain. The crew from Access 7 happy to bring the game. Cougar action tonight on Access 7 Sports. Cougars, very impressive. And this one, Aaron McGowan with it, ball fake.
I think this is actually the best the Cougars have looked all season from what I've watched, for sure.
And they spent about a week or just under a week in down south over Christmas break, playing games, playing a tournament there, getting everyone kind of minutes and just game. Getting some games in, and that I think is obviously served them well. They got to meet their new center, who's still kind of working his way back into basketball shape. Learning the offense as well. I know that's another thing that it's always a work in progress. As a university team, you're kind of always putting plays in and tweaking stuff and new wrinkles. I mean, you added player midseason, it can be a little bit tricky.
Yeah, definitely. It's going to be interesting to catch on, and we have seen in the past games Burrow's put in different defenses as well, so he has to pick up on those as well. So it'll be a tough transition, but hopefully with his teammates, he'll be able to figure it out.
A steal there by Brandon Tault. Gowns is getting in the lane at will today. Can't get the shot to go. Curry goes the other way. Spartans doing a good job getting the foul line.
I think this is going to be a long end to the game if the fouls are both team fouls at four each.
Four fouls apiece here. 5:25 to play. Vanderbilt's back out there with his four personals. The line. Fraser, Curry. And the next whistle, we'll see Sam Hillis check into the game, number two for the Cougars. Everyone who's got a jersey on for the Cougars has played tonight. The exception of Brandon Buttazzoni, who's, we're told, nursing a bit of an injury. Travis Sylvester also out for the Cougars right now.
Actually, if Sam Hillis scores when he enters the game, every Cougar will have scored as well in this game. So it's always exciting.
Quick turnover by the Cougars. And the Spartans are going to call a timeout, talk it over. 5:15 to play. 40-point Cougar lead. There's a drive by Manis. He kicks inside to Smith, lays it in with his left hand. Big rebound by Brian Ofori. We found a cutting round in Talu. He just weaves his way all the time in to get those looks.
You know, he's kind of a shapeshifter that way, but this is the best play of the game so far, I think. Maybe the dunk, but, I mean not the dunk, the block, sorry, on that three-point shot earlier in the half, but that was great by Brian Ofori. Just completely shows his athleticism. And the pop's just towering over everyone in that huddle right now. Take a look at the smallest guy there. That's Kieran Hebert.
Yep. Had one of the red shirts there, Josh Exner. And a few other guys on the bench there sitting out. Colton Bellamy, Jeremy Sver, Matt Augustine. So Cougars will be loading up for next year. A lot of players back.
I think they lose.
Lose a couple.
Yeah, two players next year. And Jonathan Tull and Will Tallman, which are some pretty big losses.
Yep. The Cougars lead it by 30 here, 89-59. Nice block by Ofori. Sam Hillis picks up the loose ball, finds McGowan. McGowan with a nice cross. And he'll go to the line.
Aaron McGowan listed at 6'1", 170 pounds, and I think that's why he gets sent flying a few times when he goes into the key there.
Gowan got 13 on the game.
Got five players for the Cougars in double digits. Brian Ofori having a double-double with 11 rebounds and 13 points. Solid night for him.
One-point lead. Cougars led by 24 at half. They really put this game away in the second quarter. And another foul. And the Spartans continue to go to the foul line here in the fourth quarter. This will be Spangle.
Yeah, they've now shot 29 free throws on the game. Cougars have shot 27, so there's been a lot of fouls called in this game.
And picks up the loose ball. Cougars a little sleepy there on the foul shot rebound. Eliason for three, no good.
Another offensive rebound. Good work down low by Trinity Western. And Coach Burrows isn't going to be happy with those offensive rebounds.
90-62 right now. Regina in the lead. 4 minutes and 10 seconds to play here in the game. Cougars is trying to get it over the line here. Sam Hillis, shot fake into the lane. Just the floater. He gets hit hard and he'll go to the foul line.
It's a good take there by Sam Hillis. Shot fake and blow by. You can see Pops come back into the game. Steven Shields. Burrows probably just wanting him to get a few minutes with the offense and the guys.
It's a second and two.
Now every player on the Regina Cougars has scored.
There you go.
And actually almost every player on Trinity Western has scored too, except Spangle. So we'll see if he gets in on the action here. A little errant pass,
yeah. That's a friendly way of saying
it.
Yeah,
that's what you're gonna call it.
Cougars lead by 29 big ones. 3:44 to play here.
Nice rebound there by Pops. Nice finish there by Brian Ofori, working against the shot clock.
Ofori. To lead back up to 31. Rogers, Spangle, Eliason, watched by Hillis. Block inside by Ofori, finds McGowan. You really want to get Pops the ball. Here he is, on the block over his right shoulder.
Not happy with that, I thought he got fouled a little bit. Just looking at the stat sheet here, it's pretty clear. I mean, you've got five players for the Cougars, and he goes 11, 18, 13, 7, 9, 14. You've got a bunch of them scoring. And then you look at Trinity Western and it's still 14 and 22.
Yep.
They need to somehow get someone else involved in this offense.
Yeah, they're going to potentially give up 100 points here.
It's been a pretty back and forth fourth quarter. Pretty steady with the scoring here. But just as you said, the Cougars kind of put this game away in the first half. Nice move.
Vanderbilt goes glass.
You see there's three players for Trinity Western right now, four fouls out there.
Go for it. Was looking high low to Enjai.
We call that one an errant pass too?
Yes.
Perfect.
That's the one thing I think Coach Burrows is going to talk to his team about after the game is some of those unforced errors they made. Really no need to make that pass there.
They have 11 turnovers in this game.
Vanderbilt for three. McGowan comes away with it. Ofori for the
tag. He is so fun to watch, isn't he?
95-64.
I think I've been waiting for that all season.
He has a few huge ones. Again, unfortunately, they came on the road. Couple big ones here, and that's a nice one for Brian Ofori. Kind of punctuating a great night from 17 points, a double-double.
4 blocks as well.
McGowan goes to the basket, hits the deck. Ofori Can't get it to go. Rushed it maybe a little bit. Madison's going to the basket. Kick it to Spangle. And he hits the three, so back-to-back triples.
And now everyone's scored in this game.
Yeah, so. You get a basket, and you get a basket, and you get a basket.
It's Oprah.
Yeah.
Oprah basketball.
Oprah basketball, yeah. Yeah, that's... Coaches don't really like that, though, unless you're winning. That means not a lot of defense, but team basketball for sure. McGowan to Ndiaye. Can't get it to go. 50 seconds to play. Eliason for three.
And if you're a Trinity Western, this is exactly what you want going into the game tomorrow. They've hit a few threes here to close out the quarter.
So a little 9-0 run here. A 9-2 run from Trinity Western. It's got them back within 20, 23. McGowan's going to dribble it out as much as he can. Seven on the shot clock. Take the screen from Ofori. Shot clock violation by the Cougars.
I think McGowan might have just waited a little bit too long to get that play going. Just kind of put Malika in a tough position there.
Mike's like, hey, come on, man.
What do you mean you're giving me the ball now?
Eliason, no good. Ofori with another rebound. And that'll do it. University of Regina Cougars with a convincing 95-72 win over Trinity Western. And we'll take a look at that alley-oop. There you go, Megan.
This is just this. I could watch this all night. This is a perfect pass from McGowan. And just an amazing finish there from Brian Ofori.
And 17 and 15 for Brian Ofori. And the highlight of the night, that dunk. Cougars win at 95-72. For Adam Hunter, Megan Chamberlain, and the Access 7 crew, thank you to everyone who put this together tonight. Thanks for joining us on Access 7 Sports for University of Regina Cougar Basketball.